Hello and welcome to Tranny Star Galactica. I'm Sama. This is Domenico. It's week 125. Diana asks. Diana's questions over here. Pretend you are a seer. Give us your predictions about mankind for the next 3 years. Bonus question. Share one or two of your favorite accessories.
Well, it's coming from
I think same-sex marriage is going to be much less of a deal. As time goes on, I become more and more sure that the meat doesn't matter.
It's okay, Lilo. I'll make it better.
Generation Y has a very strong sense of self-expression that I think is going to benefit a lot of minority populations. I wouldn't say I'm worried necessarily, but there's a certain sort of misery in the next generation. It just seems like there's plenty of boredom and kids these days just don't seem as happy with the status quo as they could be if they had a chance to explore and express more. So I'll be interested to see what happens. I'm not going to try to tell the future on that one, but I see it coming, and I don't think it's a long shot to guess that's true. So the bigger issue for me is the ever-growing... The issue for me is the ever-growing trans population of septuagenarians and older. Because those are the people whose families may or may not have abandoned them. Those are the people who are leaving employment, will be living on a mediocre social security. Those are the people whose problems we're going to have to solve in general, but there's a trans population that is going to need us, is going to need the next generation to pick up and care. And I do believe we owe it to them because we have the privilege of their leadership and we have the privilege of their guidance. A lot of trans seniors have left marriages, have left children behind, or their children have left them behind, I should say. And it's painful to see because there's so many magnificent parents with children that they absolutely adore, but who don't have the same regard for them. And so, I think we would all do well to sort of, I don't know how to say this, this is ageist of me, but sort of adopt a senior trans parent and just give them some gratitude for who they are, because it's by who they are that we can be who we are. And I don't think there's any other force so beneficial to us as those who paved the way from Stonewall on. So, if I have 3 years to sort it out, I'll spend that 3 years gladly doing two things. One, helping trans youth remember their sense of self and explore those things, find help, find support, safety. And two, finding someone in the aging population that I care a great deal about, at least one person, and there are so many, and reminding them that they are worth so much and that every bit of the rest of us who have the rights we do and the fact that the rest of us know what rights we have to fight for is because of them. And to give them that regard and respect and humanity in other areas of life, because we are more than our gender. And we have so much to thank that group for. Be well. Oh yeah, by the way, my favorite accessories that I never leave the house without are my glasses and my wedding ring. That's about it. I'm a pretty simple guy.